Welcome to TalkNorth.com. Thanks to our longtime producer, Brandon Morton. Please download before you listen. If you'd like to advertise with us, you can reach us at TalkNorthPodcast@gmail.com. And please follow us on Twitter at TalkNorthPod. Two promo codes to be aware of. BiteSquad.com, use the promo code TalkNorth to get your first delivery free. And go to SodaStick.com, the great local apparel company. Use the promo code YouBetcha to get free shipping on any sized order. Jon Krasinski is in Las Vegas. I could make a Vegas joke here, but instead I'll just ask you what it's like.
Well, I'm the Vegas joke, I think, is what you is. I mean, I've only been here, two and a half days, and it feels like I've been here for 2 weeks. So, as you know, as we've discussed on this pod, I'm not the biggest Vegas guy, but it is a necessary evil at this point of the season. So, here we are.
So, is there something you do like about Vegas?
The plane ride home.
Really? So you don't have any fun while you're there?
Well, I mean, while I'm here, I got to make the best of it, right? Like, I got to do what I can. I mean, I can't just sit in my hotel room and pine for the lakes and the humidity of back home. But yeah, I'll get out. And the one thing I do like about Vegas, and I do like about Summer League, is that everyone is here. The entire league is here. All, you know, kind of my buddies that are writers around the league are here. So you get to get face to face with them. You grab some dinner, you grab some drinks, you watch a ton of basketball, and you just, like, I mean, walking into it, I was at the Wynn the other night. I was walking down the hallway and bumped into Andrew Wiggins right there. And like you bump into Coach X or Scout Y, and so it's really good that way for networking. It's really good for just chatting with people and doing all that. But everything else, I can pretty much flush down the toilet. So,
did you look into Andrew Wiggins' eyes?
I did. Yes, I did. And Glenn Taylor did yesterday as well. At the game, we're recording this on what day? Yeah, it's Tuesday. So at the game on Monday, they sat next to each other. And if you're asking me, have I seen the eye of the tiger now all of a sudden? And do I see, like, the beast being unleashed? I can't say that, but I can say that I did actually see him, which is totally different from last summer when he was completely gone and not around at all. So maybe that's a good sign. I don't know, but he's the enigma that they have to try and figure out for sure.
The enigma is Jon Krasinski in Vegas not, like, having the greatest time ever. I mean, I guess you're not 16 anymore. But
I'm a 40-year-old parent right now, so I don't have the fastball that I used to have.
Well, I do remember those days when I'd go to a great city and I, you know, had kids at home, and I would just think, this is great. I get to sleep a little bit.
Yes. And that's the advantage. Is like, okay. I can sleep past, you know, 9 o'clock for one day, but your body is trained. Like, listen to me complain more about my job that sends me to Vegas, but your body's trained by this point to be like, you wake up at 7:15, and no matter what time I go to bed or whatever, I'm waking up. So I can't even take advantage of that.
This is the Jon Krasinski Show, also known as the You Betcha Basketball Show. John writes about the NBA and the Timberwolves for The Athletic. I'm Jim Suhan from the Star Tribune. This is all part of the TalkNorth.com podcast network. And our other basketball show in the network is the Cheryl Reeves Show. And thank you to our sponsor, TSR Injury Law, 612-TSR-TIME, and BiteSquad.com. Use promo code TalkNorth to get your first delivery fee waived, but then keep using it because BiteSquad's a great company that's been very good to us. So let's start with that. Let's start with the fact that last summer you did not see veteran Wolves players in mm-hmm. Vegas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was, you know, it was really the canary in the coal mine, Jim, last year, where I was out here for Vegas. There was literally no player except for, I think, Anthony Tolliver, who had just signed and was here because of a players union meeting, and he's a, you know, a big bigwig with the Players Association. And so you see every team, like Portland, Damian Lillard and CJ McCollum, you know, the Lakers, LeBron showed up with the Lakers and he had just signed with the Lakers. You had all, yeah, every team has their players, James Harden, Chris Paul, they all come and watch at least a game or two of Summer League, of the Summer League team, and hang out and have fun in Vegas and do all that stuff. But there was not a Timberwolf to be seen, and no Jimmy, no Karl Anthony Towns, no Andrew Wiggins, no anybody. And so that was like, you know, there was always these kind of rumors at the end of last season that chemistry wasn't good, things were not going well. And those were brushed aside by the Wolves kind of front office and all that. Say, hey, you're making a big deal out of nothing. We just went and made the playoffs. Everything's fine. But that was the first sign that, boy, there's, you know, this is not good. Like this, we can't find anybody. And so now this year, you have seen Andrew Wiggins. You have seen Karl Anthony Towns working out with the guys. You have seen, you know, we said Jake Layman and Noah Vonleh, some of the new guys as well. And so I just think that that's, it doesn't mean that they're going to be great next year. It doesn't mean that everything is fine and dandy, but it at least is a sign of some sort of stability, some sort of connectedness that certainly wasn't there last year.
So I'm a little disturbed, though, because Summer League would be a great time to, like, get the new group together. And Russell Westbrook isn't hanging out with Kat.
I know. It's this must be another one of those secret recruiting sessions, right? Because when you tamper, it's best to tamper in the shadows, Jim, not out in the middle of the Las Vegas Strip. So I'm sure that's what's going on with that.
Is there any chance, I've been shooting this down left and right, is there any chance of Russell Westbrook ending up with the Timberwolves this season?
You know, it would very much shock me, Jim. You look at the situation here, and Russell is obviously a dynamic talent, but he is an ornery individual to be around. He has an enormous contract, 4 years, $171 million left. In the year four of that deal, he's making $47 million, and he's on the wrong side of 30. So you look at all of those things and you say, boy, I don't know, because one of the talking points that Gerson Rosas has been giving out here in Vegas is they are looking for players that align with Karl Anthony Towns' timeline. And I think that was one of the big problems of the Jimmy Butler era, was Jimmy was far more advanced in his career than Towns and Wiggins were, and so it was a bad mix that way. And so, you know, when you look at bringing in a Russell Westbrook, that would be another trip down that path of young players with an older player that really, really wants to win now, and how does that work? So all of that is evidence that I would say, boy, I don't think it's going to happen. I'd be really shocked. I'll tell you the one caveat, though. The caveat that I look at is, if you did it, and if you got off of Wiggins' contract, if that's like a thing that you want to do, Wiggins has a bad contract right now because it's 4 years, $122 million, and you don't get much production for it. You don't get what you need that way. Russell Westbrook has a bad contract, but you get major, major production, at least in, you know, maybe year one and year two before his body really breaks down. And so given that Gerson Rosas is kind of from the Daryl Morey school of when star players become available, we got to be in on them and we got to be checking, it would not surprise me at all if he's at least called, if he's at least said, hey, what are you looking for? What would it take? And there's some sort of mild consideration for it. But I don't think, I just don't see a scenario where they bring him in here. to this young core and try and reinvent what they did with Jimmy Butler with Russell Westbrook.
Yeah, well, you know, that is the one way I could see it happening, is if there's any way to combine teams where you get rid of Wiggins and bring in Westbrook. I'd rather have Westbrook's kind of a bad contract than Wiggins' kind of a bad contract. I mean, I don't see it happening, but that's the only way it would make any sense to me. In terms of contracts, Tyus Jones gets the big offer sheet. And, you know, the way I've been answering this is people ask me is, hey, I love Tyus. I'd love to have him. I don't know if that's the right number for the Wolves in their current cap situation, but you tell me, you're the expert.
Yeah, that's another one. I talked to a bunch, like, I want to say four or five different executives with other teams just to say, hey, if you're in the Wolves situation here, what do you do with Tyus? They all have said, hey, it's a really tough decision. One, you know, yes, the number is a little bit higher probably than anybody would like to play for a backup point guard. But two, if you lose him, you don't have a whole lot at point guard. You have Teague, Shabazz Napier, who came over in the trade with the Nets and Warriors. So you don't have a lot of stability there at point guard, with Teague coming off of a year where he was really injured with that foot. So one part you say, yeah, why not match it? He's analytics darling, can start for you if you need him, but can also play the backup role. Good teammate, good in the community, all that stuff. Go ahead and match it. And then if you decide in a year or two that you need to trade him, you know, an $8.5 million contract is going to be tradable probably. So you look at that and you say, yeah, why not match it? But then on the other side, one thing that's clear already with what Gerson Rosas has done in the offseason, he traded up in the draft, was looking for Darius Garland, didn't get him, got Jarrett Culver. So he was looking for a point guard at number six. He went hard after D'Angelo Russell, another point guard. So I think it's pretty clear in the actions of the Timberwolves in this new regime that they don't see Tyus as a long-term starting point guard for them. And so if you don't see that, and if you want to try and reclaim some salary cap flexibility going forward, maybe you do just let him walk and then go forward with what you have right now, look at some other deals that you can make, and then go next summer. Priority number one would have to be finding a running mate for Karl Anthony Towns.
I want to get to the explosions in the NBA landscape and also have John introduce some of the new Wolves players who are a little under the radar. Do want to thank TSR Injury Law, 612 TSR Time. If you go to TSRinjuryLaw.com and you need their help, or you want to check into whether their help is right for you, you can use their contact sheet and tell them what your case is like. You will not pay them a penny unless they win your case. Or you can always call 612 TSR Time. Steve Terry and Rich and everybody else and Nate, they're cool people. It's a Minnesota company. And if you ever need their kind of help, they are the right people to provide that help. 612 TSR Time. We're doing a show at TSR Injury Law soon with Steve Terry and John. So let's start this segment here. Chip Scoggins from iPaper wrote something along the lines of, hey, gotta please Cat. And he's not wrong, but look at Kawhi Leonard. Kawhi Leonard goes to Toronto. They treat him great. He's in one of the great cities in North America. It's a big, beautiful place with everything you could possibly want. It's like a clean New York. He becomes a national hero by winning a championship with the Raptors. They built a team that perfectly complemented him. They coached him well. He liked it there. Everything went great. And he left as soon as he could. So I know that the idea is right. Hey, Wolves need a please Cat. But it doesn't really matter if you please players or not. They're still going to do what they want to do.
Yeah, look, I was having a conversation with someone last night about the Kawhi situation. And look, if it can happen to the Spurs and the Raptors, two very well-run organizations, one coming off a championship, and if a player like Kawhi, who is so understated, pulls like what he did, it can happen to anyone. And so in that respect, yeah, I don't think that you can sort of live life in fear of Cat leaving. Like, that's not the way to do it. I mean, you know, this organization really capitulated to KG back in the day quite